Greetings, y'all. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade, back playing some more Farming Simulator 17. We're back at Sosnovka, and we bought an entire fleet of New Holland equipment. Got some new trucks parked over there in the distance, got our harvesters, and it's time to start buying some implements for this stuff, so let's get to it. First, we need front loaders for these. There they are. They have two sizes. I think the small ones will handle the big ones. If not, we've got bigger ones to, look, we can even change the color. Let's get New Holland blue. Okay. Let's try that first and see. Oh, look, it kind of went in at an angle. Now, I think I've got the attachers on this. Yeah, I've already do. So we'll connect that to that. Let's see if it works. Well, it looks like it works. Alright, so we'll just get the big ones for all the tractors then. Let's see, what do we want for this though? The small tractors we probably need to put on sheep. So I need pallet forks and a weight. Pallet fork. We can have a different color. Let's go New Holland yellow. Okay. Need a weight too. Here we go. Now these you can't have different colors on the sewers, I don't think. Nope. It's the ag code that you can. And I don't think I need that big of a weight. I think this one will do just fine for our small tractor. I don't think I'm gonna color these. I could do it yellow, but I don't know. Yellow would make them easier to find because I'm always putting these things down and losing them. And black is hard to find. That's what made it hard on 15 was trying to find them. I'm just going to do a New Holland yellow. All right, let's see. Where did it go? Where's it at? Is it inside? Yeah, it is inside. How about that? One thing, they don't have the, they don't have the exclusive New Holland front loaders on 15, just the Stoles, but you can change the color, so, I don't know, it's not that big of a deal. I think that's New Holland yellow, it's pretty close. It looks like New Holland yellow, or not yellow, blue, I mean. So let's go get our weight here. Bet it's turned around backwards too. I'm gonna have to go around. Oh, I can't see. Let me just go end cab for this. Alright, I think that'll be enough weight just for wool pallets, so. You know what I really need? I need an equipment trailer to haul all this equipment around instead of driving it, you know, all around the map. Because I got a lot of equipment. Alright, so I'm going to just... Okay, here's the rule. Over here on the right, it's ready to go. So there we go. Alright. Turn the engine off. There. Where we got our next one? Where do we want it? Well, probably need one with a bale fork. So let me get the big one. We'll just do blue again. With a bale fork. Now I think we had another one that was a mod. Yeah, it's the same brand too, so. You can pick up more bales with this. So I'm going to get that. Why not? Let's just keep it going. Get the New Holland yellow there. Oh, and I need a weight. Just get the same weight for this tractor. This little tractor, anyway. Oops, no one buy two. Did I buy it? I don't think I bought it. Yeah, I did. This new buying system is different. Just have to get used to it. That's not as tall as it looked in the ad. Oh! That's why it's not as tall. Look at that. So, you can extend it up and down. So if you wanted to pick up one or two, and then extend it up to more than that. Okay, well, we'll leave it down for transport. I have to remember that. Switch back and lift it up a little bit. Let's go get this weight. Let me just go into inside the tractor for this. I need to get this big equipment out of here. Alright. Let me just back on out. Alright, this equipment here is ready to go. Oh. Gotta get used to the controls. Alright, T6s, they're equipped to handle the front loaders as well. So, let me get some weights for them. Hang on. Okay, these tractors, the T7 will not do front loaders. And these will, so I need to put the heavier weights on the back of them. So I want to buy two 2,300 pound weights. Because we may end up doing logging with them. And logs are a lot heavier. And I guess we'll just do the standard yellow again. Why not? Alright, I got a couple of those. Now I need the front loaders. This is pretty cool, I think. This is a mod that was released. It's the same as the log fork, but it's got two on it. I think it stabilizes the log more when you pick it up, so. Do we need that right now, though? What do we need? That's a bucket. Tell you what, I'm just going to get the forks right now, the actual arms. Just for right now. Where's my other weight? Oh, it's back in there. Until I decide what I want to put on these. Because like I said, we may do logging with these. I'm just going to park this right behind that one. Did I leave that other tractor running? I did, didn't I? Alright, let's run back to the next one. Now let's see, that's the wide tire one. Right? And this is the narrow tire. Yeah. Let me go get that white first. Cannot see. Wonder why that spawns in at an angle like that. Kind of weird. All right. And this one's ready. What's next? These are next. Let's see. These. Okay, no front loaders for them. Don't really need. Well, I guess I could put a weight on the front. Wait a minute. I hear a tractor running. I left that tractor running. That's going to get me in trouble. I can see it now. I might as well go ahead and buy a fuel tank. Let me buy a couple weights for those, just for the front. I don't think I need a 2300. I don't think I need a 1500, maybe an 1100. Go ahead and buy a couple. Now one of these is wide, I think, and one of them is regular. Yeah. This is regular and the other one's wide. Well, that's a big weight, isn't it? Do I need that big of a weight? Brings the front of the tractor down. It's pretty big. Let me see what the next size down is. 1100, 650. I think 650 would be too small. 1100 is what I got on there. I'll stick with the 1100. Oh, let's see. What do I need? Baling. I need to get into baling. The big baler, of course. New Holland. What else do we need? Really want to get into this coon stuff. I want to do the bell wrapping and all that, so. Is that the square wrapper? I think that's the square one. That's the one that does both the round and round wrapping. So yeah, we'll get that. We'll probably get that later. Go ahead and get this going here. So that's ready to go. Okay. Switch back to the next one. Go get the front thing for it. Okay, I know that's in front of me. Why is it not? That should pick up on that, right? There we go. I just wasn't close enough. Alright, what do we need? I'll tell you what, I'm going to get these tippers right here. Just for now. We'll get our cedars later. The best thing about this is I can back it up and hook up this one trailer with it easier. There we go. Get turned around here and we'll be ready to go with this one. I'm going to park it actually on the other side of the other one, I think, because it's so long. Oh well, no, I can put it over here. I am going to definitely need an equipment trailer though. Let me go ahead and, let me turn my engine off. And let me find an equipment trailer. Low loaders. Flatbed low loader. That's a mod. I've done this one before. It attaches from the front. It's kind of weird. This one is good for small stuff like tractors. You know what? Since I haven't done it before, I'm going to test this one out. I want to see what it's about. And there goes the heat. Where's it at? There it is, right behind me. Ooh, that's gonna be hard to get to. Let me get one of my trucks here. Probably need a big one. All right, you can see with the crop damage on the wheels that takes the grass out too, so we can't drive on any crop. Just to demonstrate, I wonder if I can do it on these and it'll do it. Yeah, see that? It does it to them too. So no driving on crop anymore. I like the mod. It's not realistic to drive on the crop and it not damage it. So I've got that mod in. It's going to be a part of everything that I have now from now on. So I really like it. I hope it has ramps that come out. If not, that could be a problem. Get it over here and see if we can demonstrate it or something. May have to turn my help on. Where's help? There it is. Alright, install ramps. Well, that's weird. Remove ramps. It's like Back to the Future. They just kind of hover out to the side magically. It's like a hoverboard. Okay. Well, I like it because it's wide. That means I can put the big equipment on there like this guy. I think I can. I don't know, those ramps don't really look strong enough to hold a big thing like this. We'll try it and see. Am I even? I don't know, it may not be wide enough. Oh. Oh. Come on. Nope, it's not wide enough. Back up. Abort. Abort. Okay, so we tested that trailer. Doesn't work. It would work for small stuff, but I mean, the other thing that we have is just as good for small stuff, so I'm going to sell that. Sell this trailer. Although it does have beacons on the back. That's pretty cool. I don't know. I don't think it's wide enough, and you can put straps on it, so what could we use it for? Let me go get one of these small tractors. And these may be too small. Up and raise my fork here. These may not be. Well, it's working. I don't know, I guess it works okay for these. Alright, well, wonder if I could lift my front end up and drive a little further. Ooh, I don't know, it's kind of going the wrong way. Come on. Hey, yeah, there we go. I can do that and make more room on the back there. Wonder if I can strap that down. Well, that's giving me the logo. Or the thing there. I don't know if that really fastened that or not, but I don't think you can fasten equipment anyway. Alright, well, I'll put these little tractors on there at least. I can use it for that, I guess. Take these and deliver them to where they need to go. The last one needs to go to the... This one needs to go to the sheep, and the other one needs to go over... It's got a bale fork on it. It needs to probably go to the cows. Up under there. Alright. Gonna put a strap across that. Let's see if it'll work. Yeah, it didn't go across it, but it may still hold it. We'll see. Alright, let's get back in the truck and see. Let's see, what is that? I got additional control here, guys. What does that do? Oh, I'm in the tractor. Never mind. I thought I was in the truck. I was like, what does that control? Alright, let's see. Remove ramps. Fasten belts. Unfasten tension belts. I guess it has its own belts. Yeah, it looks like it has its own belt system here. And maybe that's for all the trailers. I don't know. But I'll go ahead and fasten them. And remove the ramps. See how that works. Well, it looks like it's going all right. All right, well, we'll deliver these and I'm gonna park it right here for now. No, they're moving. Those ramps don't hold them. So, ooh. Yeah, they're skidding around. They're skating around on there. Look at that. Okay, so we'll just have to be really careful with these. To not, you know, skate them around on there too much. All right, well, we've reached the end of another episode. So until next time, guys, remember you reap what you sow. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade.